This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this video is going to be about expected value. So let's take a look at a problem and understand what expected value is. Let's say we've got a game that we can play. The game involves a spinner. To play the game, you pay $10 each time you want to play. Then you spin the spinner. We have a circle with 8 equal sections. If you land in one of the sections, you're going to get $24 back. If you land in another section, you'll get $12 back. There are 2 sections that will give you $10 back, and the other 4 sections have a payback of $5. Now, if you only play this game once, you really don't know what the outcome is going to be. There's an equal probability that you could get any one of these sections. But if you play the game a lot of times, let's say thousands of times, then the law of large numbers is going to say that you're going to get each of those sections approximately 1/8 of the time. So let's see whether it would make sense to play this game a lot of times. I'm going to make 2 columns so we can record some information. In one column, I'll put the probability of something happening. And in the other column, I'll put what happens. I'll just put a dollar sign for that column, since what happens is you're going to get some money. So for 1/8 of the circle that we're dealing with, you get $24 back. And for 1/8 of the circle, you get $12 back. For 2 of the sections, so that's 2/8, you get $10 back. And then for 4 of the sections, so that's 4/8, you get $5 back. Now, if I add up all those probabilities, I've got 1/8 plus 1/8 plus 2/8 plus 4/8, that adds up to 8 over 8, which is 1. And we want that. We want to make sure we've accounted for all the probability. Now, what I'm going to do is multiply each of the probabilities by the outcome, by the amount of money you get for that probability. So let's see what we get. 1/8 of the time, let me move this $10 over. We want to make sure we remember that $10. 1/8 of the time, you get back $24. So 1/8 times 24 is $3. And 1/8 of the time, you get back $12. Well, 1/8 of 12 is $1.50. 2/8 of the time, or 1/4, you get back $10. And 1/4 of $10 is $2.50. And 4/8 of the time, or 1/2, you get back $5. And half of $5 is also $2.50. So let's add all those numbers up. But before we add them up, let's remember one other probability. I'm going to put that down here. We have a 100% probability. I'll write that as a percent, that you're going to pay $10. So let's leave that as let's put that as a negative 10. Okay, and we want to multiply 100% times that negative 10 that you're paying. So that's going to be negative 10. And now let's add all of this up. Okay, so we've got $3 plus $1.50 is $4.50, plus $2.50 more is, let's see, $4.50, $5.50, $6.50, that's $7. Plus $2.50 more is $9.50. And then we have to subtract $10, because that's about how much it costs you to play each time. So we end up with negative 50 cents. Let's put a dollar sign in for all this. In other words, if you played this game a lot of times, hundreds of times, thousands of times, on average, you would lose 50 cents each time you played. Okay, so let's review what we did again. Basically, we take the probability for each outcome. The outcome has to do with, in this case, how much money we would get. We multiply that probability times that outcome and record that answer. We do that for each of the probabilities and each of the outcomes. We add all that together and we include the probability, the 100% probability, that we're going to pay $10. When we add all that up, both the money that we're going to get back and the money we've paid, we find out whether our expected value for playing this game is positive or negative, and how much it is. If the expected value were positive, this would be a great game to play. You could play it over and over and over again, and on average, you would keep getting money. If it's negative, you don't want to play the game, because the more you play it, the more money you're going to lose. Okay, so that's basically how expected value works. Take care. I'll see you next time.